This object is sitting still, while this one is accelerating, right? Yes, if you ask Newton. But Einstein's theory of general relativity says it's the other way around. This one is accelerating upwards, while that one wasn't accelerating at all. You've probably heard from somewhere that gravity is not a force, but rather the warping of space-time. You might have also seen this demonstration to illustrate it. This fabric, which represents space-time, gets distorted by heavy objects like the sun, curving the paths of planets. While this paints a pretty picture, it's crucial to understand that this is only an analogy, just like the analogy that magnets work because opposites attract. It's not meant to be taken literally. First of all, space-time doesn't look like a sheet of fabric. It looks just like everything around you. Space-time is the three spatial dimensions, length, width, and height, plus the time dimension. And we combine the two because Einstein realized they're much more closely connected than they may seem. So how does the warping of space-time make things attract? To understand this, let's first look at the motion of objects through flat space-time, not yet curved by mass. This is a graph charting height over time. A stationary object is represented by a horizontal world line, which includes all the points where the object exists in space-time. As time passes, the object follows along its world line, and its height remains at zero. If I give it an upwards push, its world line is now diagonal, spanning across both time and space. Rewinding back to when I was pushing the ball, you can see that accelerating objects have curved world lines. Now, let's head back to Earth. Here, gravity makes things fall. Why? Gravity causes space-time to warp, while the world line of a non-accelerating object is still straight. But when you draw a straight world line through curved space-time, something funny happens. Now, as time increases, my height decreases faster and faster. Because we can't see curved space-time with our own eyes, if we were to plot what we saw on a space-time graph, we draw this. The line appears curved when really it's not. Now let's revisit the start of the video, where I cryptically claimed that this is accelerating upwards. Because this table is applying an upward force against the object, the world line is curved in such a way that it hugs the time axis. So now as time increases, height remains constant. This world line looks familiar, doesn't it? Bam! The world line of the object sitting still on Earth looks exactly the same as that of the object I accelerated upwards in space. And that's because they're essentially the same thing. In fact, if you put a scale in each situation, they both detect weight. And that's why in general relativity, they're both considered to be accelerating upward. This realization that standing on Earth feels equivalent to being in an accelerated frame of reference is called the equivalence principle. And Einstein deemed it the happiest thought of my life. So there you go, a visual understanding of space-time curvature in two dimensions. We could take it to a third if we really wanted to, but our eyes can't handle anything beyond that. Fortunately, mathematics has no problem dealing with many dimensions. So, was Newton wrong about gravity being a long-distance force? Wrong is a strong word. Both Newtonian mechanics and general relativity are just mathematical models. Newton's model is simple and offers a great approximation for our daily lives, which is why it's still taught in school. But when objects are too heavy or move too fast, it begins to fall apart. Why should we care? Well, it turns out that many things, including GPS satellites, depend on the accuracy of general relativity. But remember that back when Einstein was still working on his theory, he had no idea how it would be useful. He just loved exploring the unknown. And it's this passionate curiosity that leads to breakthroughs.